नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। I welcome you all with my love and respects. Siti is sitting with us in two-way video conferencing, having Nayana Diksha, Vancouver, Puri. Are you able to see me? Vancouver, Puri, you are able to hear? Yes. Calgary, Amarnath. New Jersey, Omkareshwar. Guadalupe, Rameshwaram. Monterrey, Mexico. San Diego, Tirualavai. Isleworth, London. London, Kashi. Yes. Oman, Sivagangai. Phoenix, Kanchipuram. San Jose, Madurai. Singapore, Singapuram. Seattle, Chidambaram. Toronto, Kailasam. Oklahoma, Somanatham. New York, Varanasi. Los Angeles, Arunachalam. Charlotte, Srisailam. Atlanta, Ujjaini. San Jose, Madurai. Singapore, Singapuram. Alchemy process of transforming you is called Kriya. These 2 days, I'm going to help you to go through the alchemy process of you transforming yourself. Nitya Kriya means the eternal alchemy, helping you to go through eternal alchemy process. I don't need to waste much time in the introduction because I know most of you listen to the satsangs regularly. Most of you are satsangis, are already connected devotees, but I'll straight away enter into the subject. First, I wanted to introduce these 4 important principles of life. Only with these 4 important principles of life, you can understand death, you can understand life, you can have answers to all the questions related to life. Now I can see Ohio Prayag. Ohio Prayag, I welcome you. I wanted to introduce these 4 principles of life to all of you. Please listen. The first principle, integrity. Integrity means honoring the word and thought you gave it to yourself and to others as your life. Dhyan se suniye, listen please. Honoring the word you word and thought you gave it to yourself and to others as life. Second principle, please listen. Because in this 2 days session, again and again, I am going to repeat these principles. Again and again, I am going to make you experience these principles. Integrity means honoring the thought and the word you gave it to yourself and to others as your life. Authenticity means in any point of time, you being established in the peak of your capability and responding to life from inner image, who you perceive you to be, outer image, who you project you to be to others, and others' image, what others expect you to be for them. I'm defining authenticity. I'm introducing these three words. Listen. Inner image, outer image, others' image. What you perceive as you in you. The idea you carry about you in you is inner image. The idea you project about you to others is outer image. And ideas others expect from you is others' image. Listen. What you feel as you is inner image. What you project yourself to be for others is outer image. What others expect you to be for them is others' image. In all these three, being in peak, having highest, best inner image for yourself about you, projecting the best image about you to others, and fulfilling what others expect from you is authenticity. Listen. The image you perceive about you is inner image. The image you project about you to others is outer image. And the image others expect from you about you is others' image. Being in your peak in all three is authenticity. What you feel, what you project, and what you make others expect from you. What others expect from you. In all these three, being in your peak is authenticity. Please listen. Blessed are those who feel they do not know these principles and listen again and again about it. Fools are those who think they know all this already. So please listen. Just today morning, one of my brahmacharini, she wrote from Malaysia. She told me, Swamiji, every time when I listen about these four principles and talk about the four principles, I discover something new. I said, that is why they are called eternal principles. Sarva Bhaumya Vrata, it is just like sun, as old as age and as new as today. Can you all see the square I am trying to create is your body? You may ask why it is in this way. Because your body is this way, so I am also putting it. Inside this body, what you feel as you is inner image. Inner image. In Sanskrit, we have a word mamakara. Sanskrit, we have a word mamakara. And the way you project you to others, see, all these different people, the way you project you to others, this is mama ahankara, outer image. Or ahamkara, in Sanskrit we have a word ahamkara. Yes, then what others expect from you, how others expect you to be for them, that is anyakara. Listen, being in the peak of what you perceive yourself to be for you, what you project yourself to be for others, and what others expect you to be for them. Being in the peak in all these three is authenticity. Now the usual question arises, why should I care about what others think of me? Please listen, when you expect others should fulfill what you expect from them, they also have the right to expect what they want from your life. Authenticity is fulfilling, expressing yourself in the peak in all these three. The third principle, I'll repeat, inner image is what you feel as you for you, outer image is what you project as you to others, and others' image is what others expect you to be for them. Being in the peak of all these three is authenticity. Third principle, let me expand on third principle. Responsibility means living and responding to life from the truth that you are the source of and therefore you are responsible for all happenings in and around you. Please listen. Living and responding to life from the truth that you are the source of everything. So, therefore, you are responsible for all happenings in and around you. I am not asking you to understand this principle immediately, existentially. I just want you to understand this principle linguistically now. Understand linguistically, that's enough. This principle can be experienced only when you see in the life. When you take the responsibility and see the benefits, only then you will be able to understand the power of these principles. Only when you practice it, when you pull these principles into your life to make it into reality, only then you understand these great principles as part of life. Now please understand linguistically, that's enough. These 2 days, I'll be helping you to make these 4 principles as experience. It will be most beneficial for you if you bring your life to the program and take the program to your life. Means applying these principles by internalizing. Internalizing means analyzing for the purpose of internalizing, is internalizing. Listen. We analyze many times for the purpose of rejecting. Here I am asking you to internalize. Analyze for the purpose of internalizing. The mandatory condition for you to get this program is listening. Please listen. Again and again, spiritual teachers tell you, how much ever you listen, if you don't practice, you will not see the result. I tell you, how much ever you try to practice, if you don't listen, you will not see the result. People say listening is supposed to lead to practicing. I tell you, practicing is supposed to lead you to listening. Listening is the result. Each time you listen, you expand. Each time you listen, life happens in an expanded dimension to you. Listening, listening, listening. Catch it. Don't miss even a single word. Don't even miss the gaps. Listening. So understand, the 3rd principle, responsibility. Living, thinking, feeling, responding to life from the truth that you are the source of everything. You are the source of everything. So, you are responsible for all happenings in and around you. 4th principle is enriching. Enriching means you taking responsibility with integrity and authenticity that you are committed continuously enriching, expanding yourself and life in and around you. You are committed to continuously enriching, expanding life in and around you. Please listen, these are the four basic principles of life. Only with these basic principles, the ABC of life starts. ABC of life starts only with these four basic principles. All the questions about life can be answered. All the doubts of the life can be solved. The ultimate doubt of the life, the death itself, can be demystified with these four principles. This program is all about making you understand the four principles of life and preparing you to live a pattern-free life, and when time comes, experience pattern-free death. Please listen. While you live, you tie yourself, bind yourself with so many patterns of fear, desire, guilt, laziness, pain, sufferings, so many patterns bind you. By enjoying them, you also bind them. The mental patterns, life stuck with mental patterns, and death stuck with mental patterns. Life stuck with mental patterns, and death stuck with mental patterns. Is hell. Please listen. If your life is full of mental patterns, your death will be full of patterns. Don't think your life can be different. And when you are about to die, some angel or God, somebody will land and your death will be different. No. You are going to die exactly the way you are going to live, and you are living. Sometimes people ask me, especially Hindus, they say, oh, at the last moment of death, if I say Rama, Krishna, Shiva, Hari, Govinda, I will reach heaven. Why should I suffer whole life? Why should I repeat God's name whole life? Why should I do something? Oh, whole life you will be chanting Coca-Cola, pizza, and suddenly, while you die, you will remember Rama, Krishna, Govinda. What do you mean? It's impractical, just postponing attitude. So please listen. In these 2 days, I'll help you to apply these four principles to solve many of the questions you have about life, especially help you to live pattern-free life, bondage-free life, and experience graceful exit when time comes. Experiencing graceful exit when time comes. So I'll help you to crash through many of your emotional layers, layers of patterns. The first layers of pattern you need to crash is fear. Dhyan se suniye, please listen. The first layers of pattern, layer of patterns you need to cross is fear. Fear is neither your thought nor your emotion. It is absence of your consciousness. Please listen. It is just like when an owner of the house is not there, the house is available for anybody to encroach. Same way, when your consciousness is missing in your body is now available for anything, anybody, that is fear. It is literally having a two-legged board on your body, two-legged board on your body. Fear is neither a thought nor an emotion. If you are thinking, it is a thought and trying to solve. If you are thinking, it is an emotion and trying to solve, you will be a failure. Be very clear. It is absence of your consciousness. Only by invoking your presence, fear is conquered. To conquer the fear, nothing else is required other than invoking your presence. Listen, invoking your presence inside you is what I call integrity. Invoking your presence inside you. Dhyan se suniye. Now, the words you give it to you and give it to others, neither you are aware nor you take responsibility, because you are not aware. You don't want to take the responsibility. You don't even feel responsible. Dhyan se suniye. First thing you need to do to remove fear in you, bring awareness in your thinking, the words you give it to you and the words you give it to others, infuse awareness, bring awareness. Society continuously teaches you the words you give it to others you have to fulfill, because it is related to society's stability. It expects you to fulfill the words you give it to the society, because it is related to the stability of society. If everybody starts lying to everybody, society will lose its stability. So society wants its stability, so it teaches you, please fulfill, honor the word you give it to others. But I tell you, honoring the words you give it to you is the first thing you need to learn. I am not saying don't honor the words you give it to others. I am saying you have to, but this part of you, honoring the words you give it to you, you never attend to it. You take yourself for granted. When you take you for granted, everybody else is also going to take you for granted. Only when you start honoring the words you give it to you, you will even start becoming aware of the words you give it to you. A small story. One guy opens his lunch box in the office and finds garbage and cries, "Oh God, I don't like it." Next day again he opens the lunch box and cries, "Oh God, again today also garbage, I don't like it." His colleagues were really surprised. The friend's wife is so cruel, knowing every day, knowing the friend doesn't like garbage, every day she sends garbage. Third day again, the friend opens the lunch box and cries loudly, "Again garbage, I can't take it anymore." The friends asked him, his colleagues asked him, "Your wife is so cruel, she cooks every day garbage, knowing that you don't like it." This fellow slowly responds, "No, I'm not married, I cook for myself." Listen, most of the time you do not know what you are doing to you, and what you are doing to yourself. I wanted to know, please raise your hand, how many of you cognize that you do the same thing to you? Again and again you do not know what you are doing to you. Please raise your hand. Let me see. So you all need integrity. First thing you need to do is swapurnatva, complete with yourself. Whether it is NDY or NKY or inner awakening, first things first. Without that we can't move. Without that you can't move to the next step. I tell you, you need to complete with you first. Now I'll give you a few minutes. You need to sit and remember, please listen, not only you don't complete honor the word you give it to you, you don't even bother about it. Let me describe. See, integrity means if you say you will give $1 million to somebody tomorrow, even by giving your life, you have to honor the word. If you are not able to honor, you are very clear, even if you give your life, nobody is ready to buy you for $1 million, you won't be able to honor that $1 million, at least telling that person now itself that I complete with the word I gave you, I will not be able to give you $1 million, I drop from that commitment. Even that is integrity. Please listen. Even if you say you will not be able to do it and relieve you from that commitment, that is integrity. Either honoring or completing. Either honor a word you gave or complete the word you gave. Same way with you. You would have told yourself in the young age, I'll become a doctor. That's a big fantasy all the kids carry. because of the pain of the injection, in my young age, I used to do that. Whenever I see anybody more powerful than me, I'll feel like I will become that when I grow up. My first decision is, I'll become a great sculptor and carve all the deities I want for myself. The young age, my first desire is to have the deities, all deities. And you know, the sculptors, naturally they ask money. So I used to feel powerless in front of them. See these fellows, I wanted to worship these deities. I wanted to have them. He is not giving me. He is asking money. All right, when I grow up, I'll become a sculptor and carve all the deities as I want for myself. The next day when I was taken to a doctor, I saw him very powerful. Then I decided I'll become a doctor when I grow up. So whoever you feel as a powerful in your life, you decide to become that when you are young. Please listen. If you desire to become a doctor and you became a doctor, great. You have honored your commitment. But if you have not become the doctor, at least you should complete with you. All right, I have not become doctor. I am not going to become one in my life anymore. The possibility is not there. So I complete with myself and I drop that desire. I am complete with that desire anymore. Even that is integrity. Listen. Now I give you a few minutes to complete with you. Sit and pen down all the words you gave it to you but did not bother to fulfill. Honor. If you already honored, don't worry, you don't need to pen down. Pen down those words. But any words you have given it to you and to others, if you have not honored, please pen down. Few minutes time for all of you to restore your integrity. Restoring your integrity with you is the first step in spiritual life. All the commitments you gave from the young age, please listen. All the desires you cherished are nothing but the commitments you gave it to you. If you cherished eating ice cream, pizza, taking a walk in the beach, everything is the desire, the commitment you gave it to you. Every commitment you gave it to you and did not fulfill, honor. Please pen down. Please listen. Now I give you a few minutes. Sit in meditative mood. Whatever you think you can't fulfill immediately in next few days, even if you think something you can fulfill after 6 months, don't keep that as a pending incompletion. Whatever you think you can't fulfill it immediately, complete all of them. Okay? Tell yourself, I am not interested in fulfilling it. I am not interested in honoring this word. For various reasons, I cannot honor it. So I am dropping it. Please sit straight. Close your eyes. Now whatever you wrote, the words you gave it to you, which you can't honor, please complete them by declaring to yourself. Declare to yourself and complete them.